What's up guys, this is Balázs from Racing Brick. Today I'm going to talk about not one, but two exciting products, but let's roll back the time a little bit first. As you know, I'm very much interested in anything related to LEGO Powered Up, and I try to show you all aspects and possibilities of the platform. When Spike Prime was announced a year ago, I was very excited because it added a lot of very interesting new hardware components to the Powered Up ecosystem. Unfortunately, Spike Prime was released by LEGO Education, and traditionally their products were not available through LEGO.com, but only through specialized resellers. This situation, however, changed this spring when some of these sets appeared in the regular LEGO webshop, so I had the opportunity to get the Spike Prime set for review. First, I wanted to do a separate video about it, but as the new Mindstorms set was announced, I thought it is a great opportunity to unbox and test these two side by side, to check out their similarities and also try to understand the differences. Please note that this video will not go fully into the details of both sets and all the coding possibilities. I will test and show you these sets as a regular customer who is interested in the advanced capabilities and would like to go beyond the standard Control Plus Technic sets or Boost. I don't have an EV3 set to compare to, and I don't have much experience with that one, so I won't be able to give you insights from that perspective. Here are the two boxes side by side, well, even the appearance is very different. The Mindstorms set has a conventional LEGO box, but Spike Prime is something new. Let's open this plastic bin and see what's inside. There's a quick start guide here, a set of stickers and two plastic bins, and lots of plastic bags inside. There are 9 numbered bags, 2 unnumbered ones, big plates and frames without bags, and all the electronic components. I wanted to make sure that I understand the concept properly, so I started with that recommended web page even before doing anything. Here you need to select the product first, then as the first step we get an introductory video about Spike Prime that guides you through the hardware elements included in the box and a brief demonstration of the app. It is important to note that the video is addressing teachers and not the students directly. So here is the third step, what to do with the box. Remember, this is a LEGO education set, so it is designed to be used in classrooms. If there are only 45 minutes to find all the necessary parts for a build and also do the coding part, then everything has to be arranged properly. The two white trays are there to hold the contents of the 8 numbered bags, and there are even stickers to apply for a quicker sorting. The mysterious bag number 13 has spare parts that can be used if something gets lost. It's nice to see bigger parts there and not only tiny 1x1 pieces as usual Technic spares. Now everything is sorted, let's jump to the Mindstorms set and see what's in there. This box looks more like a regular LEGO box. On the front you see the 5 robots to build. The 5-in-1 text also emphasizes this. Unfortunately, you can only build one at a time. The back of the box is really crowded, they try to squeeze in a lot of information. We get to know the names of the different robots and a lot of accessories are also visible that we can build for them. Let's open the box and see what we get. For the first sight, it does not seem to be as organized as the Spike Prime box. Apparently we get 14 unnumbered bags, a Technic base plate like in the Spike Prime set but this time in teal, the electronic parts and a small quick start guide. If we have to open everything at once, then it will be a real challenge. Honestly, I don't think only classrooms need some structure and order. The top and the bottom of the box has some kind of sorting guideline that you can use, but I'm not sure if this is really effective. If you have a fixed place on your table for two huge paper boxes, and you don't want to move them around possibly for weeks while you are building the different robots, then it could probably work, but otherwise the plastic trays of Spike Prime are very, very missed here. A nice surprise, we get a sticker sheet that seems to be free to use and apply. This is not something you see often in LEGO sets. The quick start guide begins with a potential disappointment, but it is totally understandable with such set that requires a smart device to work. There are only digital building instructions. There are a lot of new parts, we finally get the Defender Mudguard in white, so you can build your white version now. There are tons of new teal pieces, the wheels from Spike Prime in black now, the new differential and so on. We get again a sneak peek at the different builds, but there are no further hints besides the app to download. I think I should do that now, but before jumping to the apps, let's compare the electronic parts we get. The cable seems to be identical, we also get the hubs that I will open in a minute. There are 3 motors in the Spike Prime set and 4 in the Mindstorms, and 3 sensors versus 2 sensors. So these are the medium angular motors, they are totally identical except for their color. The cable is white for both, which is funny, because the Technic large angular color is grey, but with black cable. The Mindstorms set has 4 identical angular motors, but there are only 2 of them in Spike Prime, and an additional large angular motor. This is the distance sensor, which is the same in both sets. It uses ultrasonic technology, and it has a 4-segment light output around the eyes. It also provides access to third-party hardware through a connector at the back. The color sensor also comes in both sets. It can detect colors, light, and it can be also used as a light output. There's one sensor in Spy Prime that is exclusive to the set, the touch and force sensor. According to the Mindstorms designers, they decided to add more motors and less sensors to extend the possibilities of the set, but the force sensor is available for purchase separately. Now to the hubs. As you see, apart from the color scheme, they are totally identical. 6 ports on both, same internal name, it is called hub number 6. They have an internal speaker, an accelerometer and a gyroscope, and a 5x5 LED matrix on the front. The batteries are also the same, although the text is pretty difficult to read on the teal one. Now let's see the apps. The Spy Prime app is only available for tablets and desktop computers, so I won't be able to test it on my phone. If I start it for the first time on the tablet, there's a quick overview about the set and the concept, and then a reminder about the preparations for the teachers. And now we can turn on the device. It is interesting that the update can only be performed via cable with a PC. The other powered up hubs can be updated with their mobile apps as well via Bluetooth. So this is the update being performed on my PC, takes only a few minutes. After the update, we have to name our hub and we are good to go. When we first connect to the hub, there's a basic step-by-step tutorial to create an emoji on the hub. This shows us how to add code blocks and how to run the program. The next section uses the motors and the sensors with some basic builds to demonstrate some of their functions with the corresponding code blocks. The building instructions are clear and easy to follow, although these are not the 3D instructions we could see in some other LEGO apps. There are different small sequences showing us the capabilities of the motors and sensors, and also the hub's built-in gyroscope. This is good to get familiar with the components of the set, but I did miss a tutorial on the app's interface itself and about the handling of the hub. I thought that I will have to use the different smaller builds I just created going forward, but the next lesson requires to take them apart. It's a bit annoying. I know the hopper only uses a few pieces, but still. After this intro, we can get a bit lost if we are trying to use the app on our own, since there are different unit plans to download. If we check the first one, there are different lessons listed. Each lesson has a corresponding lesson plan that you can check online, and it provides really detailed information for teachers. This is where we realize why this is a LEGO education product, and why it was not sold to regular customers in the first place. In this form, I think it really works in a classroom environment with the support of a well-prepared teacher. Obviously, everyone can explore the lessons on their own, but that's not the primary goal. If I compare it, for example, to Boost, the app there and the whole concept is built to teach basic coding principles through the app without additional help and guidelines. Now let's take a closer look at the Mindstorms app and see the difference of the approach there. When we open the app, there's no basic introduction like in Spy Prime. We see the 5 robots to build and that's it. I find it again a little bit weird, no tutorial about the app itself, how to use it, what is the basic concept with the hub. There are so many basic questions. I know that kids are encouraged to discover these things on their own with trial and error, but I think at least parents should get some guidelines if they are asked about specific functions. There's a help section explaining the code blocks in details, but again, no basic tutorial. So, let's get back to our first robot. The build of Charlie starts with the head, and we have to start building immediately. So, no numbered bags, no sorting tray, I will need to open all this. There was a much better concept already used in Spy Prime, why couldn't that be implemented here? As I really don't have much building space at the moment, I tested a new method. Instead of spilling all parts on the table, I carefully opened the bags and picked the necessary parts directly from them. It was not very comfortable, but sort of worked. After the assembly of the head, we need to connect the hub. Interestingly, this time the update works wirelessly. Not sure why Spy Prime was insisting on a cable connection for the update. After the update, we get a code sequence that is ready-made. We only need to connect the hub and run it. There are instructions how to connect to the hub, but it is worth to read every bit of the description and also check the tips, since they can contain vital information, especially if you are not familiar with the platform. Here it is explained how to start and stop your program that is downloaded to the hub. Okay, it means that the code does not run from the app by default, some new information that is not explained in details. The next activity is to build Charlie's body. The tips are essential again. You really need to pay attention to align the motors to the zero position, otherwise some functions won't work. As the next tip says, there are numbered slots in the hub for the programs, and you can switch between them by pressing the arrow buttons. It's great to see these in a step-by-step tutorial, but I wish they would be available somewhere else in a structured form. After the assembly, we get the code fully made, with only a single tip to explain one of the blocks. The blocks themselves are kind of self-explanatory, but it's weird that they don't have any help or extra information that you can access directly. As I mentioned, there is a help section through settings that is a huge wall of text with information about the blocks. I wonder why this information is not accessible easily through the blocks themselves. How should I be able to find the blocks by name anyway? After section 3, Charlie already has his arms and we get a specific model block that calibrates him. The code becomes pretty complex quickly. If you don't understand it for the first sight, then it is really worth to spend some time and study it. Apparently, this is the only way the app tries to teach you about coding. The final build only has a few steps. Altogether, it takes about an hour to build Charlie. He's a really cute fellow, and he's dancing happily when he's completed. After the basic build, we can download several activities. Each of them has additional accessories for the robot. The concept of the four other builds is similar. There are sections for the build and then the different activities. As you see, with the five robots and all the corresponding activities, you get tons of possibilities to build and to code. I really like the five different robots with different abilities and the way that you can spend a lot of time with one robot build through the activities and the accessories. So, this was our first round of Mindstorms vs. Spy Prime. There are still a lot of things to explore. Here are a few thoughts that I can already tell you about the differences. Spy Prime is really a tool for education. It works best in a classroom. Although you can buy it at lego.com, I only suggest to get it if you exactly know what you get. You either want the parts or you want to use it to teach coding with Lego. The Mindstorms Robot Inventor set, however, is more versatile. Although I would not suggest it as a very first step to learn about coding. It will still work since we get ready-made programs for each build, but it lacks the ease of use and the detailed explanation of the coding concepts and the blocks themselves. I really hope the app will be updated with a tooltip help for each block, pretty much like what we have in the Boost app. So as a first step, I would stick to Boost, and then comes Mindstorms. As I said, there are still many things to explore regarding this set. I will try the other builds, the remote control possibilities, and also the ability to mix it with other powered up hardware. Please let me know your thoughts in the comments. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. You can also subscribe and tap the notification bell if you don't want to miss my technic reviews and other LEGO RC videos. See you next time, bye bye!